Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
After criticizing the BJP for 5 years and resolving to contest elections alone, why has the Shiv Sena decided to stay on with its old partner?
हमारे जवान तो शहीद 4 साल में जितने हुए उतने 50 साल में नहीं हुए।
अगर मामला अदालत के पास ही डालना है तो फिर चुनाव के प्रचार के दरमियान उसका इस्तेमाल ना करें और फिर बता दो कि भाई और बहनों हमें माफ करो, ये भी हमारा एक चुनावी जुमला था।
Among the BJP's allies, the Shiv Sena has been the strongest critic of the Narendra Modi government. And yet, ahead of the Lok Sabha and Maharashtra assembly polls, the two parties have announced an alliance.
महाराष्ट्र में और देश में भारतीय जनता पार्टी और शिवसेना इन दो पार्टियों ने फिर एक बार साथ में आने का निर्णय लिया है।
In the Lok Sabha elections, the BJP will contest 25 seats, while the Shiv Sena will contest 23 in Maharashtra.
Shiv Sena BJP alliance of late has been a kind of a marriage of inconvenience. They are extremely inconvenient staying together, and they are even more inconvenient if they are separated. So what they have done is they have opted a lesser inconvenient option of staying together, but it will stay on paper because having had this kind of warlike situation for last 4 years, talking of separation and challenging the BJP and criticizing even to the extent of joining Rahul Gandhi.
In the state elections, after keeping a few seats aside for smaller allies, the BJP and Shiv Sena will contest an equal number of seats. The Shiv Sena may also get its candidate as Deputy Chief Minister if the alliance wins the state polls. The Shiv Sena says the alliance has been formed keeping the interests of people in mind.
और आगे बढ़ेंगे तो साथ में हाथ, सिर्फ हाथ नहीं, साथ मना नहीं।
The BJP has seen its vote share in Maharashtra rise over the years, and in the 2014 polls, it was higher than the Shiv Sena. If the two parties contest separately, the Sena will be a major loser. But it will hurt the BJP as well.
After the demise of Mr. Thackeray, things went really difficult for the Shiv Sena, and alliance started wobbling only after that, because two Hindutvavadi parties can't stay in the same space, so one has to have to go on the back foot. That Shiv Sena was not willing to concede, but eventually it accepted the reality. Had it not done that, it would have been damaging for the BJP for parliamentary elections and more damaging for the Shiv Sena in state assembly and subsequent municipal corporation elections.
The Shiv Sena had little choice but to ally with the BJP, since it risked its leaders being poached by the BJP and the Congress-NCP alliance.
Shiv Sena, in a way, is facing an existential crisis. So it was compelled basically to have some kind of an alliance with the BJP. And BJP, after the SP-BSP alliance in Uttar Pradesh, also thought of basically giving a second thought to Shiv Sena. Shiv Sena workers on the road will find extremely difficult to reconcile. They might have had an alliance, but eventually on the ground, things may look little different.